It's 2024 and I bought myself an Apple baseball. Let me show you why. I've been using She Who Shall Not Be Named for a long period of time now. The problem is, I don't use any Amazon services, so all I'm doing with her is to turn on the lights, the TV, switch the channel, and so on. I have a YouTube Premium subscription, and I want to be able to use that. That's not possible. I try to find workarounds. Using YouTube Music Player in Home Assistant, for example, will allow me to connect Home Assistant to the YouTube Music service. Then I can theoretically stream that sound output to some wireless speakers. Sonoffs are really good, and I'll be able to spread everything around the house. So like anyone, I started digging around to see what voice assistants are in the market, what is the best model that I can choose. You have three big providers. You have Apple with these HomePods, you have She Who Shall Not Be Named, and you have Google services. The problem with the HomePod was that Apple requires accessories that are HomeKit compatible. So you have multiple devices like I have, you need to make sure that they're indeed HomeKit certified. This was a big problem for everybody since, hey, they will be more expensive, harder to find, and so on. But that's not a big problem because I have Home Assistant. All we have to do is go to Settings, Integrations, HomeKit, and if we click on configure, we can select the domains to be included. Click submit. Now we can select all the entities, air conditioner, lights, and so on. Click submit, finish, and it's done. Everything will be automatically sent to the HomeKit bridge and of course your new HomePod. So this solves the biggest problem with compatibility with third-party devices. Another extra thing for this HomePod is the ability to integrate YouTube Music. Since I have a YouTube Premium subscription, I have access to YouTube Music and I want to be able to use it within the house. All I have to do is say something like, Siri, play Justin Timberlake.
One moment. Justin Timberlake now playing on YouTube Music.
Siri, stop playing. It's that easy. After a 1 minute integration, I can now call my voice assistant from the phone, from the HomePods, from my watch, from everywhere I want to go. And with Thread also being supported on these devices, I don't see any competitions for them, even if this is an old device. Let me know what you think. Do you think these HomePods are still useful in 2024? Well, if you're looking to purchase a voice assistant or try to replace the existing one, I hope I answered a few of your questions. If you found this video useful, please don't forget to like and subscribe.